Happy day, students. Let us see now sound wave in the form of density. And we know that density is written as mass by volume. Okay, and we already know that the sound wave is written in terms of bulk modulus. So bulk modulus is what? Beta equal to minus of dp by dv by v. Okay, so dv by v is actually here minus dp by beta. Okay, this is dv by v. So if suppose I am going to differentiate this term with respect to volume, what is going to come? Why with respect to volume? Because density is variable, it's changing, and volume also changes. Mass is constant. So if I write d rho by dv, what's going to come? Let's see. M is constant. Okay, differentiation of v to the power minus 1. This will be minus 1, v to the power minus 1, minus 1. Okay, that means minus m by v square. Okay, now this we can write as d rho equal to m by v dv by v. That's dv by v. Okay, now dv by v, if you remember, dv by v, when you were deriving pressure equation, we wrote it as dy by dx. Okay, dv by v was dy by dx. So what we can do, we know already the displacement equation. The displacement equation is y equal to a sine over cosine of omega t minus dx. Okay, so dy by dx will be what? Dy by dx is minus a k cos omega t minus kx. I'm going to put it over here. Okay, so d rho equal to minus m by v dv by v, which is dy by dx, which is this, minus a k cos omega t minus kx. Now this is initial volume. Okay, this initial volume means this we can write as density initial. So this d rho we can write as rho naught ak cos omega t minus kx, which is very similar to dp equal to beta ak cos omega t minus kx. Exactly similar equation. Okay, here also you can see cos, here also you can see cos. So that means density wave and pressure wave are in same phase, and both of these are actually have phase difference of pi by 2 with displacement wave. Okay, so this is density wave, you can remember that. Now let us see velocity of sound wave or velocity of pressure wave. Okay, but before that, let me tell you one question normally will be asked. They will give you a displacement equation or a displacement graph like this. This is y and this is x. And they will say you that this represents a longitudinal wave or pressure wave. It represents pressure wave. So find where is compression and rarefaction. Okay, where is compression and where is this rarefaction? So, if you remember, the equation dp was beta dy by dx. This is dv by v. Dp by dv by v is minus beta. Now, dy by dx, here this is y, this is x. That means this is slope. Okay, this is slope. So then, what we can say? If the slope here, we can find out where the slope is positive, where the slope is negative. Okay, if I am going to make the pressure wave also here, pressure wave is like this. Okay, now here pressure is, or rather slope is positive. And slope is positive. Slope is positive, dp is negative. That means here is less pressure. It's a rarefaction. Okay. When dy by dx is negative, where is dy by dx negative? Here. When dy by dx is negative, that means dp will be positive. When it will be positive, that means it's a compression. Here pressure is P naught plus beta ak, whereas here it is P naught minus beta ak. Is that clear? So we have to be determinant, or we have to be able to determine what the slope is. If the slope is negative, pressure is positive. If the slope is positive, pressure will be negative. You understand? If pressure is coming negative, means it's a rarefaction. If pressure comes positive, means it's a compression. Okay? So now let us see velocity. What is velocity of sound, velocity of pressure wave, or velocity of longitudinal wave? Okay, so let us see again. For velocity, we are making again a cylinder, same way. The cylinder is the piston, okay? Its area S. Now, if you see here a zone in which the gas is, okay? Suppose here, when you are compressing it, here the pressure, let's assume, is P naught plus P. Okay, P naught was atmospheric pressure. When you brought it closer, its pressure increases to P naught plus P. And here pressure is P naught plus P plus D on this side. Okay, and because of this, this disturbance is moving in this direction with an acceleration of A. So if I write it in terms of forces, P naught plus P into area minus P naught plus P plus dP into area equal to mass into acceleration. Now mass is what? Density into volume. Density into S, and this one we can write as dx, or you can write it as x. Rho into S into x into acceleration. Let's say acceleration is A. Okay, so this S is cancelled throughout. P naught plus P, P naught plus P is gone. So here we are getting minus of dP equal to rho into x into acceleration. Acceleration we can write as whose acceleration? Okay, acceleration of wave. Okay, so acceleration here. Now, if this I can, it's better that I write it as dx. Okay, now bring this down over here, minus dp by dx equal to rho. Now this acceleration I'm writing as d square y by dt square. Okay, so acceleration we have written as d square y by dt square. Okay, then what we can do? We are going to differentiate these things which we have already, like dp by dx. Okay, dp value we have, which is beta ak cos omega t minus x. We'll differentiate that. Okay, so this will come what? Beta ak as it is. Differentiate this, this will be minus sign omega t minus kx. Okay, then again, differentiation of this thing, omega t's differentiation will come 0 because that's constant. This will be coming as minus k. So minus k. So what we are getting? Beta ak square sine of omega t minus kx. This is dp by dx. Okay, place it over here. So minus beta ak square sine omega t minus kx. Okay, equal to rho. Now d square y by dt square. Now first of all, dy by dt we have to write. What is dy by dt? And then again differentiation. So y is what? Y we have written a sine of omega t minus kx. So dy by dt will come what? To be a differentiation of this cos omega t minus kx. Then differentiation of this. So its differentiation will come omega, because you are differentiating with respect to time, and kx differentiation 0. Then again, one more time, d square y by dt square. So a omega constant, differentiation of cos is minus sine omega t minus kx. Then differentiation of omega t minus kx, which is omega again. So what we are getting? A omega square minus sine omega t minus kx. plus d square y by dt square. We'll place it over here now. So minus a omega square sine omega t minus kx. Okay. So here also sin omega t minus kx, here also sin omega t minus kx. This is getting cancelled. Okay. Then this a and this a getting cancelled. Minus is gone. So what we are getting finally? Let's see. We are getting the beta k square equal to rho omega square. Okay. So beta by rho equal to omega square by k square. Now this is velocity of wave, we know it. V equal to omega by k. So V equal to root over beta by rho. Okay. V equal to root over beta by rho. If we are talking about solid, this beta, which is modulus of elasticity for liquids and gases. If you are talking about solids, this converts into Young's modulus and the formula becomes Young's modulus by rho. Now remember that velocity of sound is more in solids. Why? Because solids are more elastic. Okay, solids are more elastic. That's why velocity of sound is more in solids, then in liquids and then in gases. Okay, so remember velocity of sound depends on elasticity of the matter as well as density of the matter also. And velocity of sound is maximum in solids, whereas light is least in solids, maximum in gases, but sound is least in gases. Okay, exactly opposite. Alright, so that's it for now. Remaining things we'll see tomorrow.